continuous time signals also, we have types, that is unit impulse function, unit step function, unit ramp function, exponential signals, sinusoidal signals, and exponentially damped sinusoidal signals. First, let us see about unit impulse function. Unit impulse function, it is represented by delta of t. The graphical representation of unit impulse function is, this is the graphical representation of unit impulse function. It has zero width, infinite height, and unit area. We can say that integral minus infinity to infinity delta of t dt equal to 1. That means integration means summation. If we sum the delta of t from minus infinity to infinity, since it is defined only at 0, that is at 1, it results as 1. So this is unit impulse function. We will see about unit step function. The unit step function is represented by u of t. The graphical representation of unit step function is, u of t is only defined for positive values. For any value, any positive value, it is 1. That is u of t equal to 1 for t greater than 0 and equal to 0 for t less than 0. It is only defined for the values of t greater than 0. It is 0 for values of t that are less than 0. We can obtain some relation between unit impulse function and unit step function. That is, the unit impulse function can be obtained by differentiating the unit step function. That is, d by dt of u of t results in the impulse function. And similarly we can obtain unit step function from unit impulse function. That is, integrating the unit impulse function, we can obtain unit step function. Integrating from minus infinity to t delta of t dt, we can obtain unit step function. Since it is 1, by adding all, by integrating the values, we can obtain u of t. So this is the relation between delta of t and u of t. We'll see about unit ramp function. The unit ramp function is defined by the letter r of t, and the representation of the ramp function is, it is r of t, it is t 0. That is, for the time period 1, the amplitude is 1. For time period 5, the amplitude is 5. Similarly, for time period of n t, the value is n. So this is the model of ramp function, that is r of t equal to t for t greater than or equal to 0 and equal to 0 for t less than 0. For all the negative values of t, the ramp function is 0, and for all positive values of t, the ramp function is the value of t. That is, for 0 it is 0, for 1 it is 1, for 5 it is 5, for n it is n. Let us obtain relation between ramp function and unit step function. That is, if we derivate ramp function, we get unit step function. That is, u of t equal to derivative of ramp function. And similarly, we can obtain ramp functions from integrating u of t. That is, r of t equal to integral minus infinity to t u of tau d tau. This is the relation between ramp function and unit step function. We have seen earlier some operations, some time operations done like time scaling, time shifting and time scale reversal on some continuous time signals and discrete time signals. Now we will do some similar operations to unit step function. That is, u of t is defined from defined as 1 from 0 to infinity and defined as 0 from 0 to minus infinity. So to let us obtain u of t plus 2. The time shifting version of unit step function, that is, I'm moving 2 units to the left. As we have seen earlier, if t naught is negative, it should be left shifted. So I'm moving 2 units. It is at 0. So I'm moving 2 units to left, that it becomes minus 2. So the signal is defined like this, u of t plus 2. U of t plus 2 x of t for t greater than minus 2 it is 1 and for 0 it is for t less than minus 2. Okay, it is obtained from x of t equal to 1 for t plus 2, I mean t greater than plus 2, t greater than t plus 2. So from this we have obtained the t greater than minus 2. Similarly, we will see for u of t minus 2. Here t naught is positive. So we, as we have discussed earlier, if t naught is positive, then it is right shifted of 2 units, 2 intervals, it is right shifted. So the signal is at 0, u of t, it moves 2 units towards right, that is, it starts from 2. The signal starts from 2. Okay. So here x of t equal to 1 for t greater than 2 and equal to 0 for t greater than 2, x of t equal to 1. And for t less than 2, x of t value becomes 0. So these are some operations that can be done on unit step function. Don't know how I'm a prince here, man. All we talk about is change.